Okay, so the next step is to compile the code, and then after that we tally the code count. We may not be able to tally the case count because it will take a long time to do that. It would be great if we were to use software, so the software will be very easy to help us to get the both the case count and also the code count. But for this demonstration, we're going to limit ourselves to telling the code count. So there are three main actions that we have to take. The first one is to compile the code, and the second one is to arrange the codes in alphabetical order, and the last one is to consolidate the codes. So let's go straight to our document that we were working on. So we have all the codes here, so we first have to compile all the codes. So we select the first one, and then if you are using Windows PC, you can press on shift and hold and then press on down key to select all of them. After that, you can right click on any of them and then click on copy, so that you can copy and bring that information down here. So we have here, and then we paste it here. So these are all the list of codes under the research question. If you are using a Mac computer, after you have selected all the codes, you just have to click and hold Control and then press on C to copy, right? And then you can be able to paste. So the next step that we have to do is to arrange them alphabetically so that we'll be able to group them based on the research question that we have. So let's copy and paste it under this one and then select the list and go to A to Z sorting. So we click on that, make sure that it's showing ascending, and then you click on OK. So now you can see that the system has rearranged the codes alphabetically, and you can see that we have the first list will be the courses. Make sure that they are separated. So the courses are here, and then we have the solutions are here. So the next step is to copy this one again and put it under the last action where we have to tally the codes, and then we're going to indicate the number of significant information connected to each of the codes, right? So if you can see here, we have been a young physician, it appears two times. This means that it was connected to two significant information. So in parentheses, you type two here, and it's showing that it's connected to two significant information, and then you delete the second one. Then here, feeling inadequate is only one, so connected to only one significant information. Here too is connected to one significant information. Having numerous work-related tasks is connected to 1, 2, 3, 4 significant information. So you can just indicate 4 here and then delete the rest, right? Because we have already indicated we have 4 significant information connected to this code. So that's how you're gonna do it. Here only one, here too only one. Here one significant information, one significant information, one significant information, right? Here is one significant information and a solution. So you can see here, this is another thing that you may have to decide what you want to do. Having time with family and spending time with family, I think it's the same thing, right? Although the words are a little, one starts with having and one starts with spending. So you can decide that you can put them into one. So in this case, we can make it 2 and then delete the last one, right? Or if you are not all that comfortable, you can maintain it as it is there, and then you can, you know, continue with the sorting process. That will be our next lesson, will be the sorting process. So you can maintain it, but I think because they are similar, you can just delete here and then indicate 2 there, and then here 1. So we finished the sorting. So you can see here that the code count, every code has its code count, right? So you can see that here the code count for this one is 2, the code count here for this one is 4, the code count here is 1. We can do the case count, but it will take a lot of time for you to do the case count. So the case count is, we have to find out for this code how many participants are connected to this code, right? So we have to go back and look into where it's connected for this one, and then we know the number of participants that are connected. I think that some are very obvious because this one is 1 for case code count. We know that it might be from 1 participant because it's only 1 significant information connected to this. So this one, the case count will be also 1. But those where the code count is more than 1, it's very difficult for you to link them to the specific participant. Like this one is 4 significant information. You have to look for where we connected this significant information to the specific participant, and then you know the number, whether it's 4 or 3 participants that are connected to this code. So as I said, it's possible that it can do the case count, but it will take you a long time for you to figure it out, right? So it's not really important at this stage for you to look into knowing the number of significant the number of participants connected to each of the codes that you have. But the most important thing is you have the number of significant information connected to each of the codes that you have here. You have the code count. So I think that is okay. Oh, we left 1 here. I think this one will be 1, 2, right? So we've done with this process. So the next stage or the next lesson will be categorizing or sorting these codes, right, into categories and themes. If you have any questions, feel free to contact me. I'll be happy to explain them or address all the questions that you have. Thank you.